Hi, this is Beth. I am a registered nurse, and I've been a registered nurse for over 30 years. And you guys might not think of nurses as educators, but my whole career I've spent teaching, sometimes on a micro level, sometimes on a macro level. You know, when I was a new pediatric nurse, I took care of kids who had just been diagnosed with diabetes, and I spent time teaching them about how to draw up insulin, how to measure their blood sugar, how to incorporate carbohydrates correctly. Later on, I spent a lot of time teaching expectant families, breastfeeding classes, labor preparation classes, infant care classes. The last decade of my professional life so far, I've been spending a lot of time training professionals on different skills and certifications. And all the while, I've had no formal instruction on how to be an educator. And that's a big part of why I'm here in this instructional design program. My goal is definitely not to be an instructional designer in other settings. The purpose is for me to be an educator in my own personal setting. Now that I'm starting to incorporate the language of instructional design into my discussions with my peers, I thought magically that maybe that would make them more receptive to being more thoughtful about designing learning interventions. And I'm discovering that's not the case. One striking moment from last semester's class was when we all had to interview instructional designers, and almost all of them said there was a certain amount of resistance and pushback that they dealt with as instructional designers, and they needed to spend time developing trust and recognizing clients where they were at and helping them move forward slowly. So this is where I'm wondering about my professional training and how I can incorporate it. One big training I do with a lot of professionals is training them on a counseling technique called motivational interviewing. And it's a counseling technique that believes that we should be more collaborative with clients and less directive, and help them come to see what's best for them by making their own decisions, but guiding them in those decisions. And that idea struck me when we were reading in our book, in the needs analysis and needs assessment chapter that Dr. Van Rooij mentioned. It's really important to use language that's non-threatening, and of course to not use jargon, which as a nurse I know not to do, and be careful about explaining things in non-medical terms, but also to reframe things to help people feel more comfortable. So the most striking line was, you know, let me ask you a few questions to meet your business goals, as opposed to saying, we need to do a learner analysis and a needs analysis, because that's harder for people to understand, and it's also not focused on the client and how they want their needs to be met. So I'm going to be thinking more about this, and if anyone would like to take a free course in motivational interviewing to help them learn language to help people be more receptive and open to change, let me know.